300 to go from young Lionel. Under the whip immediately on straightening. Here comes Dust Me Off down the outside, though, with a run. Dust Me Off went up to Rebel Sun by the 200 and it hit the lead. We're looking at an upset. Dust Me Off kicks away from Rebel Sun. Young Lionel, then Full Gear running on. But Dust Me Off is pulling right away from them and back from $61 into 26. They've had a good go at this and it has bolted in a big result for the punters. Dust Me Off has won the Towton Cup.
They certainly did. I've got a very excited Paul Taffer down here at the moment trying to give Chris Parnham a nice little kiss, and he deserves it after that ride.
He's a real beaut, Chris. I think his last three rides for me, he's rode two winners in a second. So, you know, probably 2 years in between rides. But all the Parnhams can ride, and they're good kids, they're good horsemen, and they're a great family.
Now, when we look at the form, we see this horse has only won over the 1,200 metres, has struggled in recent times, but you weren't surprised at all by this performance?
No, not at all. He's copped bad barriers, bad rides all the way through. I never give up hope. That's why he's here today. We paid the 500 to get him in it, and we were quite confident. Believe it or not, at 60-1.
It's been a good turnaround, hasn't it? Because obviously it was a good run behind Planet Saline a couple of starts back, and then you were beaten by the sister, which I'm sure hurt after you sold her. Last start just didn't have much luck, but you said today the conditions, the soft track were going to suit, and just continue to power through the line.
Yeah, its mother run third in the Beaumont Guineas, and it was when it was the wettest it's ever been in years, and if you can remember when they all come to the outside rail in those years. Yeah, so she loved the rain, and I was just, you know, I thought all the way, the more I looked into the form of the others, I thought this one's on the way up and they're on the way down. So lucky enough we got there, and he won well, so that's just terrific.
You were proven right. What does this mean to the stable, Paul?
We've had a hard year this year. Like, you know, I myself had been involved in a head-on crash 4 or 5 months ago and was quite injured, and my mother's suffering now with cancer and, you know, just recently, and, you know, it'll give them all a lift. Of course it will.
Persistence pays off, doesn't it, mate?
Oh, we never give up, mate. That's the life of a trainer. If you give up, you get nowhere. So I can't wait to get over and give them all the horse and the missus another kiss.
Well, you've got a listed winner, mate. We'll let you go do that now. Congratulations.
Thanks very much, and thank you.
Chris almost getting kissed there after by a trainer. It was a great performance.
Yeah, it was good to see the trainer so excited after a win like that. So, now the horse has gone really well. Obviously, really, really improved with the wet conditions. But now it'll stay all day. So hopefully, there's more wins in store for it.
Paul said that he wasn't surprised when you did the form and had a look at the replays. Are you a little bit surprised now, going back on those performances recently?
A little bit. Sort of watching his replays, you probably thought it was a little bit out of its depth in this race. But no, obviously the horse does appreciate the wet ground. It probably hasn't been on it before. So it's really appreciated that, and got the lovely run of the race. We drew a good barrier, and we were able to get the prize, so it was a good win.
The track's been downgraded to a soft 7 now, but all reports the jockeys come in saying it's holding up really well.
It's very heavy, so it's definitely in the heavy range. It's not a soft 7, so 8 or 9. It's a heavy 8 or 8 or 9, so it's getting quite heavy out there.
Okay, mate, congratulations on the ride. Well done.
Thanks, Adam.